So what are PET scans? Most of the oncologists or the cancer specialists use a PET scan for their treatment management. So what is this PET scan we are talking about? If you like our video, please like, share and subscribe. PET scan is nothing but a positron emission tomography scan combined with a CT scan to see where all the cancer is in the body, or to diagnose the sites of the disease, or even to help in choosing a site for biopsy. So in simple words, a PET scan helps us to diagnose or stage a cancer, and it's one of the integral parts in the management of cancer. I am Dr. Vamshi Krishna Reddy. I am a medical oncologist at Yashoda Hospital, Malakpet, and I'll be talking about the uses and the indications of PET scan in day-to-day oncology practice. PET CT scan, as I said, is a scan which is used every day in the most of the cancer patients for various management levels. First of all, I'll be talking about what do we do in a PET scan. In a PET scan, we usually give a tracer or a radionuclide tagged tracer, which usually in most of the times is glucose, which is tagged with a FDG tag, radioactivity dye. So what we do is we usually inject it as we give the IV injection for most of them. So once we give the injection, we usually wait for 30 to 45 minutes for the dye to be taken up, for the glucose to be taken up by the cells and for metabolism. So once the metabolism is started in the cells, we see that compared to the normal cells, there is more hunger for the cancer cells, and these cancer cells take up more of this FDG glucose. And once the waiting period of 45 minutes is over, we usually take the patient for the actual process or the PET scan. So in PET scan, what we do is, as you can see the machine, so it's similar to the CT scan. So the patient lies down on this machine and we detect the activity of this dye we have given, radionuclide activity, we usually tag it, and we combine the imaging with the CT scan, which is also inbuilt with this machine. So we do a PET scan with a CT scan, both of them are fused later by our technicians, and we get a combined PET CT scan as what we call it. So this PET CT scan gives images which usually help us in seeing the sites of disease, where exactly we see this disease, which part of the body, whether it is lung or a bone or liver, name it, we see the site. And based on this report, it usually helps us oncologists to see and check the planning management, whether we'll push them for surgery or for radiation or for palliative chemotherapy. What are the contraindications when we should not do PET CT scan? So actually there is no specific contraindication to PET scan, because the dye we give is really safe. It has a very short half-life and it will not cause any harm later. So usually by the time they leave the PET scan, the radioactivity is gone. So PET scan is really safe. The only contraindication, or we need to be careful, is when there is a creatinine elevated, where we need to be more careful when we are giving the contrast with the CT scan. Other issue is for the diabetic patients, where we need to see that the sugar is maintained between 150 to 200 to go for a PET scan. And what are the precautions or day-to-day things which we need to follow before going for a PET scan? So once your doctor orders a PET scan, usually patients will be required to go for overnight fasting. So they will not be having food probably at least for 4 to 6 hours. If they are diabetic or they need to take some food in the morning, so we usually suggest to take salad or water. And then once there is a 4-hour fasting, we usually take them up for PET scan. We usually check an IV access, and then we also check the sugars, baseline sugars, before we go for a PET scan, and also to check for the creatinine to see if we can give a contrast. So once we check that everything is normal, we usually inject the dye into the vein and we wait for 45 minutes, and then we usually take the patient for a scan. Once the scan is over, your report will probably be ready by once the nuclear medicine physicist sees. And once the report is issued, it will be looked upon with the team of oncologists and they decide the management. What all conditions are helpful with a PET scan? So most of us think PET scan is only for cancer. The variety of indications other than cancer where we can use a PET scan, like we can use in non-cancerous conditions, like for detecting the myocardial viability, so it's used in cardiology. We use in urology to see any focus where there is increased activity in the brain. We also use it for identifying any infectious cause where there is a focus of infection and we are unable to find a cause for fever. So, these are and various indications where we use our PET scan. And we have other whole lot of activities where even the PET scan is used for treatment also. So, we usually use the scanner and we see which dye is taken up by the cancer, specifically like for the prostate cancer or the neuroendocrine cancer. Once we give this specific gallium scan dye, we know that which cells are taking up this cancer. So, later we give something called a high dose of this radioactive therapy to kill this same cells which we are detecting on a PET scan. So, even the PET scan based therapy or PRRT is what we call, that is useful in treating few cancers like prostate cancer and neuroendocrine tumor. So, PET scan has come a long way from helping us in staging the disease, to help us to diagnose cancer, to help us in doing a biopsy, to the treatment part. So, that is about PET scan. And why are we worried about the radiation? Yeah, PET scan, the radiation usually what we see with the CT scanner, it is almost the same radiation which is seen with the PET scan. So, the radioactive dye we give has a dose of 8 millisieverts, which is almost equal to the same dose as we usually see for a CT scan. So, definitely there is a radiation exposure, but it is almost as similar as a CT scan. So, instead of doing a CT and then a PET CT, most of the times we usually go for a single test which will help us in knowing the stage and it helps us scan the whole body. We usually prefer a PET scan because the dose of radiation is almost similar to the CT scan. So, that's about the PET scan. Thank you.